The dragons are back in Clash of Clans. In this video, we are going to teach you how to use the two most popular methods at Town Hall 10, the Mass Dragons and the Dragbat. Alrighty guys, let's dive straight into this. The dragons have always been popular at Town Hall 10, but in the most recent balance update, we did get a HP buff. 100 for Town Hall 10 and 11, and 300 for Town Hall 12. You know that they are good now there, but let's focus on Town Hall 10. Let's first look at the Dragbat. The first three attacks will be of that, and then we will move to the Mass Dragons for the final two attacks of the episode. But for both of the strategies, the one thing that they have in common is setting up pathing for the dragons and trying to focus on the air defense. They are the key things which are going to take your dragons down. So in this first example, we use the king and queen to snipe off that first air defense, but also just take out this top area of the base. It means that the dragons are not going to have to deal with that. They can come straight into the main portion here. They're not going to be drawn up to the top. We had a very clever use of the lava hound and a couple of balloons to come into the second air defense here, which again is very popular. If your king and queen can't quite get to it, try and get it down fast with the dragons, or if you have a clear path to that air defense, the lava hound might be a good option. Now for any of the other air defense, this is where the bats tend to come in. If you can flush out the splash damages, i.e. the dragons initially took out the wizard towers, we can now see the use of the bat spells coming into this far end in order to take out them final two air defense. Notice the placement of the bats. We waited until the dragons got within that area and both strategies merged together. If the bats went in too quick, they would have been susceptible themselves and could have gone down to splash damage. If you're new to this channel, guys, be sure to subscribe, turn on that notification bell so you don't miss out on daily Clash of Clans content, but we're going to move across to the next Dragbat attack. Another brilliant example here as to why you would use the Dragbat over the Mass Dragons. So let's check it out. As we start here, we are bringing them key principles in terms of trying to focus on the air defense whilst creating pathing. Now always think that the queen is a ranged troop, so if she can reach over one layer of wall in order to take out an air defense, you always want to try and do that. And we are again setting up pathing on this left hand side for the dragons to come straight through. Now also think about what we said in that last one. You want the dragons to take out the splash, which is the wizard towers and multis, and use the bats on the air defense or single target infernos if there is any. If we draw a line over the first half of the base, that's where all of the splash is. We can then use the bats onto these remaining two air defense here in order to help out. So we've got that push initially of the dragons coming in, use the stone slammer in order to help them with pathing, and now come the bats. Not too early, could have potentially even been a little bit earlier than this, but wanted to wait because the dragons were starting to veer off to the side. That is where potentially could have created a little bit more of a funnel here to keep them dragons on the inside. However, the base was picked perfectly here, and a brilliant example by Naughty Rabbit of Toxic Rabbits. If you're interested in joining us, maxed out Town Hall 10, 11, and 12 players, all maxed, be sure to check out my Discord. All of my social media platforms are linked in the description of this video, and you will be able to find out exactly how to join us. Now, after this attack, guys, I want to send you across to my top 5 Town Hall 10 attack strategies, because they are going to give you a lot more variety. It's pretty much everything you would need to know. It will be linked at the end of this one, but let's move to the next attack. One more Dragbat attack, then we have two attacks of the Mass Dragons. You will see that it's a little bit more base specific for the dragons themselves. That's why I would recommend you practice with the Dragbat, but they both follow them same principles. So the king and queen come over from the left hand side in order to target this air defense. But remember what I said, the most important thing is funneling for the dragons into the base. So it's pathing for them and also the air defense. defense. We're taking out this left-hand side of the base with the king and queen, and we've also took out a couple of buildings on the right, which will give us direct access to the air defense. Notice the lava hound in the composition. Very good to send into that area to tank, but clearly you don't want to send it in too quick, because then it's taking damage. You want to wait until the dragons are just about to get within its radius. So if we highlight it here, we need to wait until the dragons are virtually there. That's when the lava hound will then be useful, otherwise it's taking damage when it doesn't need to. Any rage spells that you can save for the dragons are very useful, especially if you can use them early enough in order to take down any dangerous areas. So there goes that lava hound, perfectly timed along with the stone slammer to help to flush out this right hand side. And what that will aim to do is continue the pathing of the dragons into the center. Notice the two air defense at the top. That's where the bats will be coming in. Could have potentially came in from the left hand side, but waits until that multi is about to go down and sweeps straight onto the air defense over here to the right, and that is where the bats will then move through. Any freeze spells that you have to plan out are going to be for the bats, not really the dragons, unless a single inferno happens to lock onto it, but you should never fall into that situation. You want to use the dragons to push into the base, take out as much splash, take out them air defense and dangerous areas, and then flush around the back of the base with the bats. The only time you would put the bats in potentially earlier is if you were using a bat bomb method, where you'd put the bats right into an area in order to help the dragons with their pathing. So if the bats were to clear out an area, that could help the dragons to move forward in one path rather than splitting up. Here we are then, the mass dragons. This is a little bit different. You would want to use the mass dragons if you can get easy access to the air defense. You can take all four of them out, and it doesn't really make sense to bring the bats in. You might be able to maximize on spells in order to help the dragons. If you can get two all air defense, do consider this, if it creates pathing as well. So two lightning spells are used on two sets of air defense, a lot of spells, but takes down the buildings needed. Queen is able to take this third air defense before funneling and coming up this area of the base. So we've already got a bit of pathing for the dragon's luck, because the king is also coming down this left hand side. So you can see very early on here how the dragons are being drawn into the center of the base, exactly what we need for the dragons. But think about where they will be in danger as well. Although the air defense are the main threat, there's a queen in there. There's the dragon from the clan castle in there, not to mention the sweeper, which is going to be pushing them back whilst they're trying to deal with that. So you are going to have to commit some spells to your dragons as well. In comes the stone slammer to reinforce at the top here. Beautiful use, because it would have been too slow to come in with the dragons. So really we had to use that somewhere else. And at the top of the base here, although we do have an air defense, could have been used for the stone slammer. It gets way better value down the bottom of the base, because it really is a powerhouse. It will just power through the defenses easily, and actually we can directly target the air defense at the top with a couple of balloons in the haste. Very useful to get through that. The stone slammer finally pops, but it's too late. The base is down. What a beautiful attack by Prince Melvin here of Toxic Rabbits. I mean, you can count for yourselves. Look at how many dragons he has left over. 3, 5, 7 dragons. 7 dragons, and all of them balloons absolutely crushed. That is how powerful the dragons are at Town Hall 10. Toxic Joey showing you how to get it done in the final attack here. I do want to quickly mention that anytime you watch my videos of a specific town hall level, clearly that's going to be more beneficial to players of that level. For instance, this video is going to be more beneficial to town hall 10s, but I try and educate my videos in a way that you will still get the tips needed for that strategy. So even if you're town hall 11 or 12, it really is just modifying this to your level. However, if you do want to see more Town Hall 10 attacks, I have a playlist. Head on over to my homepage, you will be able to find it. Remember what we said about easily taking out them 4 air defense. Queen takes out one, King takes out one, lightning spells for the other. Joey has taken out all four air defense before deploying a single dragon. Pretty impressive. We can now just push the main bulk of them into the center here. Although the pathing towards the back end of the base isn't as good, because you always want to think about that as well, it really is not going to matter here. Joey is able to get them dragons in, take down the queen early on. That's where that rage spell is used. And he also has a haste, presumably for the balloons popping out of the slammer, because again, if you can try and help assist the pathing of the dragons, go for it. Slammer coming around this right hand side aims to help the dragons coming through the center, and it does so much damage. If you have access to siege machines, the slammer is a must for this strategy. It will really help you out a lot. If you don't have access to siege machines, obviously I would highly recommend you try and get a Town Hall 12 to help you, because if you are high into competition, it's pretty much going to be needed. However, these strategies do still work. It's just a lot harder. We're not trying to deny that. If you have a stone slammer, that's like one mega balloon. It's going to take out a couple of defenses. It's going to be a little bit easier, but these can still be done. You just send your balloons with that haste into the right hand side in order to try and help with that pathing, but you wouldn't have them for the back end here as well. Joey going to be able to get it done. Remember guys, if you want to see more Town Hall 10 attacks, you can check out the playlist. But if you want to see the top 5 Town Hall 10 attacks, the ones that will really help you to get the 3 stars, I'm going to link a video we did recently showing all 5 of them right here. You will benefit from watching that video, so go check it out guys. But that wraps it up. Until next time, peace out.